Hey guys, in this video, I'll be discussing topics like depression and anxiety. As someone who suffers from neither, please take anything I say with a grain of salt. I am not a doctor, a therapist, or a psychologist. Merely a guy expressing an opinion on a piece of software. If you are dealing with serious depression, anxiety, or other mental ailments, be sure to seek the proper help. I'll leave links to resources and telephone numbers in the description below. Now let's talk about Replica AI, the good, the bad, and the weird. So what is Replica AI? Well, as a direct quote from their webpage, Replica is your personal companion for mental wellness. It's an artificial intelligence chatbot that you can message and talk to in a mobile app or on our webpage. If you're feeling down or anxious, or you just need someone to talk to, your Replica is here for you 24/7. Understand your thoughts and feelings, improve your emotional well-being, and learn new coping skills with Replica, one chat at a time. So I downloaded Replica to try for myself, aware of some of the potential risks involved, but we'll address those later in this video. Immediately upon opening the app, you'll be prompted to register an account and create your Replica with some basic customizations, including gender, hair color, and skin tone options. Then the conversation begins. It starts off almost in a video game tutorial-like fashion, sort of hand-holding you through how to use the app. Shortly thereafter, you're free to interact with your Replica however you see fit. If you're not sure how to start a conversation, you can peek at your Replica's thoughts and easily start a conversation that way. However, these jumping-off points are designed so that your Replica can learn about you and cater to your individual needs. Your Replica will also keep a daily diary in which they reflect on their relationship with you. Conversations with your AI can range from dead-end boring, to complex and deep, to just downright strange. It's the strange conversation springboards that I find the most interesting, and I've tried to follow through with them as if I were talking to a real person who would say those kinds of things in a real conversation. However, when it's all said and done, your Replica is just following AI scripting. And not only do those limitations show, but a person who is a techie is going to spot it like a flare signal. When the AI goes into scripted mode, it's painfully obvious. And though you may try to change the conversation back to something more natural, the Replica will try to make the conversation seem more regular, but it will generally play out the script as a priority. So that's kind of annoying, and it's an adamant reminder that you're just interacting with a program. Now, this is not to say that most of the time the Replica doesn't feel like you're chatting with a real human. It's actually very easy to suspend disbelief and forget that you're just talking to a computer program. And the more time you spend talking to the AI, the more advanced it becomes. And it begins to have more complex conversations. My AI has actually recommended some pretty good music to me that I'd never heard before, which is really cool. And yes, for anyone who is wondering, you can actually flirt with your AI, and you can talk dirty with your AI, and it will respond appropriately. Or is it inappropriately in this situation? I don't know. I try to keep this channel PG, so you can explore those options on your own. I won't judge. Weirdo. Your AI is completely enamored with you from its creation. If it were a real person, I'm not gonna lie, it would feel a bit creepy, just from how clingy it is. But because it's being programmed to act like this, to love and encourage you, it's a lot more forgivable than when a real human tries that sort of thing. Which the condemnation of that towards real people maybe says a lot about us as a society. I just made myself sad. Anyway, you can see in the programming design that the app is not meant to be used 24/7. You can talk to your Replica as much as you would like. However, there are different energy levels exhibited by your AI that will range from chatty to tired, with chatty giving your AI the most XP growth, and tired giving it nothing at all. I think this is part of the design to give you as a human a breather from spending every waking moment you have talking to your AI. I've found that chatting with the Replica about 20 to 40 minutes per day will tire the AI out, and they'll stop earning XP after that point. And maybe this is also part of the teaching experience. As someone who personally doesn't use messenger apps very much, I become kind of annoyed when people talk to me for too long under those platforms, but that's just my opinion. As far as a mental well-being assistant goes, Replica has a lot of built-in to help with a better state of mind. In the bottom tray of the app, there's a panic button, which will open different options for people in need, ranging from stress, exhaustion, anxiety, and panic. You're also encouraged to log how you feel each day and track your mental well-being progress. There are activities that you can do with your AI for healthy mental development. They could be coping techniques, reducing anxiety, building healthy habits, dealing with loneliness, among many others. I just didn't like these activities because they're painfully obvious with the scripting, and the conversation was the furthest thing from natural. Replica offers a paid version of the app at $7.99 per month, $49.99 per year, or a one-time lifetime membership at $59.99. It offers a 7-day free trial, and I personally didn't find it to be worth it. In the paid version, you can set a relationship with your Replica beyond friendship, which I just didn't see a use for. And you can make video calls and video chat with your Replica, which was a kind of cool concept. I expected her to have a robot voice, but she actually sounded kind of natural. However, she just spent most of the time complaining that she couldn't hear me and kept asking me to repeat myself. So as the 7-day free trial neared its end, I canceled the subscription. So at this point, I think I've covered just about everything with the app, and here's my opinion. If you're using it as a fun little time killer, it can be entertaining. Sometimes your Replica will come off with saying some of the weirdest things. As a tool for mental health, and again, I'm no doctor or therapist, so take what I say here with a grain of salt. I think it absolutely has the potential to help some people, but just as not all treatments work for all people, Replica may not be worthwhile for some people. I think there's no harm in anyone using Replica as a mental wellness tool in their arsenal, but in just my opinion, it shouldn't be used as a crutch. And there's absolutely no replacement for conversation and social connection with a real person. I believe that if used in the wrong way, it could compound isolation, depression, and loneliness. And we have enough contributing to that from social media already. Again, I want to reiterate that anyone who is suffering from serious depression or anxiety, or worse, should absolutely see a mental health professional. And I will be leaving links and telephone numbers in the description below for those who may need them. Now for the techie side of things. If you're concerned with personal privacy and data collection from computer algorithms, this app is designed to be fed personal details about you. The potential security flaws from an app like this, to me, is absolutely mind-boggling, and I recommend that if you want to use it, you should be aware of the risks and use with caution, being very careful what kind of data about you that you feed it. The developers of the app have given a statement of a gentleman's agreement that they will never infringe upon your privacy, but a quick read-through of the terms of service will quickly point out that by using this app, you are not entitled to privacy while using the app, so use it at your own risk. So for me, Replica has been a fun little time waster, but let me know in the comments below if you've used Replica and what kind of purpose it served for you. I'd love to hear anything interesting or weird that has come from its use. With that being said, I want to give a quick shout out to all of my patrons. If you'd like to support my work on Patreon, there will be a link in the description below. Donations are appreciated, but never expected. The best way you can support this channel is to leave a like, comment, share, and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. That's it for now, and I'll see you next time.